Students, welcome to a history class. I'm sure you all had an amazing and refreshing vacation. It's time for us to get back to our studies. So here I welcome all of you to our first semester exam. The portion for our semester is 4 chapters of history, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 2 chapters of civics. But before I continue, I would like to tell you that since we have huge portion to cover, I will be uploading whenever we have history subject on a timetable, that is on Monday and Thursday we have history lectures. On those days I will be uploading 2 videos every Monday and every Thursday. I request all of you to please watch both the videos and also solve 2 assignments based on these 2 videos. This will help us to complete our portion faster. Okay, so let us get started with our chapter 4, the freedom struggle of 1857. The points we will be covering in this entire chapter is causes for the struggle of 1857, scope of the struggle, causes for the failure of the struggle, and consequences of the freedom struggle. In this particular video, we will first understand what are we going to study in this video. We will learn the causes for the struggle of 1857, economic causes, social, political causes, discontent among Indian soldiers, immediate causes, and the outburst. We will understand all this in this particular video. So let's get started with the chapter 4, the freedom struggle of 1857. In 1857, a great struggle took place in India which completely shook the British government. This struggle did not arise all of a sudden. Earlier as well, many such struggles took place in India. The scope of the struggle of 1857 and its background was taken into consideration by V.D. Savarkar in his book called as The Indian War of Independence. Let us understand the background of Indian society. All of us know that India was ruled by the British government. The people who were there, the common people, the local people who were there, the middle class people had to suffer a lot because of the policies and rules by the British government, especially the farmers and the common people. Now the farmers had to pay, because of the new policies of the Britishers, the farmers were forced to pay heavy taxes to the British government. Now they were unable to pay the taxes, they took loan from the bank. Now since they were unable to pay the loan, the people became bankrupt. Tarz bachri hona. Peasants also are the farmers who took part against the fight against the Britishers. So this led the anger among the Indian people to fight against the Britishers. Revolts took place in states like Gujarat, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and South India. And there was this person called as Umaji Naik who helped the farmers to fight against the Britishers. This led to the anger to fight against the Britishers. He inspired people to fight against the Britishers to throw the government. He was arrested and put to death. So Umaji Naik was arrested because he helped the farmers to supported the farmers to fight against the Britishers. The Indian tribes and forest communities also challenged the British rule. The livelihood was dependent on forest resources. The British laws put restrictions on it. Even the Britishers tried to put restrictions on the Indian tribes. Tribes are the Adivasis who are dependent or who live in the forest. So the Britishers tried to change the policies or impose heavy taxes on the Indian tribes. The Indian sepoys who were there were also ill-treated by the Britishers. Sepoys means soldiers. Their salaries were less as compared to the salaries of the British soldiers. And all this led to anger burst out in the freedom struggle of 1857. So freedom struggle basically means a struggle to fight for freedom against the Britishers started in the year 1857. And that is why it is called as freedom struggle. Struggle to fight against the Britishers to get independence for India is called as freedom struggle. Causes for the struggle of 1857, economic causes, social causes, political causes, discontent among Indian soldiers, immediate causes, and the outburst. Today we will learn each of them in detail. We will learn what were the reasons that started the fight among the Indians and the Britishers for the freedom struggle of 1857. So the freedom struggle means struggle or fight against the Indians versus the British government to get independence for India. The first is economic causes. Economic causes. The new revenue system introduced by the British. So we have learned that new revenue means tax system was introduced. The farmers have to pay the taxes compulsorily, no matter irrespective of the income they earn. So the farmers found difficult to pay heavy taxes to the British government, and because of that reason, they took loan from the bank. They were unable to pay the loan, they became bankrupt. Next is, heavy taxes were also imposed on the local industries. The people of India also had set up small industries, and there were a lot of people who used to work over there. Now, since the British government imposed heavy taxes on these industries, the people had to shut down the industries because these people were unable to pay taxes to the British government. And because of that reason, people became unemployed. Since the industries were shut down, people did not have jobs, they became unemployed. Unemployment means no jobs. So all this arose an anger among the Indians to fight against the Britishers. Next is social causes. Now, British interfered in culture and traditions of Indian society. Now, when the Indians, Britishers entered into the country of India, India followed some systems, customs and traditions. For example, they had the practice of sati. Sati is an act where husband died. If a lady's husband died, the lady also has to jump along with the husband and end her life. That is called as sati. Such practices which were started or practiced by the Indian society was not acceptable to the Britishers. For them, it was completely wrong. They tried to change the society of India, which was not acceptable to the Indian society. So they stopped the Sati Act and they started something called as widow remarriage. Widow remarriage means a widow was allowed to get married. That is called as widow remarriage. So this practices was started by the Britishers, which was not acceptable by the Indian society. So they thought that the Indians are trying to interfere, the Britishers are trying to interfere into the society of India. And because of that, this was one of the reasons why the Indians were angry against the Britishers and participated to fight against the for freedom for India. Next is political cause. Now, British took charge over many states in India, including the princely states. Now, princely state means the state which is ruled by any ruler or any king is called as princely state. So, almost all the states in India were now under the control of the Britishers. Next is discontent among the Indian soldiers. Indian soldiers were given low status. Their salaries were less as compared to those of the British soldiers. Similarly, they were paid less and they were given more work to do as compared to the British soldiers. But this was all the reasons that made the Indians very angry and fight for the independence against the Britishers. Immediate causes. The British provided the Indian sepoys with rifles whose cartridges contained fats of cows and pigs. Now the Britishers gave these Indian sepoys rifle means guns. Now these guns consisted some cartridges means something to load. Okay, so what happened, this was made up of fats of cows and pigs. Now these soldiers who were there of India, some belong to Hindu religion, some belong to Muslim religion. So according to their religion, they were not allowed to touch the cow or pig, but these British soldiers, they forced the Indian soldiers to use such kind of rifles, which was not acceptable to the Indian soldiers. Okay, because of this, the religious sentiments were hurt, which led sepoys unhappy and hurt, because the sepoys were forced to use the rifles which were made out of cows and pigs, which was not acceptable by the Indian sepoys, which made them angry and inspired them to fight against the Britishers. The outburst. Now, severe punishment to sepoys who refused to use such rifles. Now, there were sepoys who did not used such rifles. They refused to use rifles which were made out of cows and pigs, fats of cows and pigs. And for them, such severe punishments were given by the British government. And there was this person called as Mangal Pandey who supported such kind of soldiers. And they fought. He shot an English officer, and because of that, he was arrested and hanged to death. Okay, so because he was trying to support this soldiers, he shot an English officer. उन्होंने गोली मार दी एक English officer को, and because of that reason, he was arrested and hanged to death. Hence, the entire Indian sepoys took part in the freedom struggle of Asia against the British. This made the Indian sepoys all the more angry and inspired them to fight against the Britishers. So here's the summary what we have learned. We have learned in this video the causes for the struggle. The freedom struggle means the struggle. People of India were so angry, they wanted to fight against the Britishers to acquire independence. So this struggle started in the year 1857, and therefore it is called as struggle of 1857. Economic causes, we learned how because of the increase in loans, taxes, people were unable to pay their taxes. They had to take loan from the bank. They became bankrupt. Social causes, we learned how the Britishers tried to stop various acts. They stopped the Sati Act. They started the Widow Remarriage Act, which was not acceptable to the Indian society. We learned about the political causes. We learned how the Indian Britishers acquired almost all the states of India. We learned how discontent among the Indian soldiers were. We learned how the Indian soldiers were paid less salaries. They were not given same respect as compared to those of the British soldiers. In immediate causes, we learned the sepoys were forced to use the rifles, guns made out of fats of cows and pigs, which hurt their religious sentiment, which was against their religion. And in the outburst, we learned because of Mangal Pandey was hanged to death, he was killed by the Britishers. The Indian soldiers became angry, and it completely changed the society. Okay, in this video we have learned the causes why the Indians felt a need to fight against the Britishers. So we stop here and we'll continue the next part in the next video. Please try to watch both the videos and solve both the assignments. Thank you.